Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. I'm very excited because I have a whole new series on PDF accessibility, and what better place to start than by providing an overview of what PDF accessibility even is. What is an accessible PDF? Well, an accessible PDF is a document that can be used by anyone regardless of disability or technology barriers. It can be accessed by the following programs: screen reader technology like JAWS or NVDA, text-to-speech programs, braille displays, and other assistive technology. Accessible PDFs can be accessed on mobile devices, zoomed in to 200% or more, or be navigated via voice or keyboard. Now, there are many different standards that your documents can be compliant to, so it's important to know what level of compliance are you going for. Typically, there are different levels of compliance categorized by the type of entity or business that you are. For example, here's a short list of the different accessibility standards that your PDF can be made accessible to. We have the Section 508 standards. We have the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, AAA and AAA standards. We have PDF UA standards, which is an international accessibility standard, one of the most rigorous standards your document can be compliant to. We also have the HHS standards. Now, these are just US standards. If you are from another country, you may have different accessibility standards to adhere to. Most organizations should strive for the baseline of Section 508. But I would encourage all businesses to actually go for PDF UA standards, which is, again, the most rigorous standard that is out there right now. So what do all these standards actually have in common with each other? They have things like document structure tags, which includes headings, links, lists, tables, artifacts, figures, form fields, and other important accessibility elements. Images have alternate text description. The appropriate metadata has been set for the file, where you have things like title, author, keywords, subject, and language applied. And the reading order has been set via the tags panel and the reading order panel. Additionally, you have tested things like color contrast. And once you have applied all of these accessibility features to your document, you can finish it off by running the accessibility checker in Adobe Acrobat Pro DC and continue fixing all of the errors that may appear in this section. Now, if you have a different level of compliance, there is additional steps that you will need to take, and I'll cover this in a future video. So let's take a look at an example PDF that is fully compliant to Section 508 accessibility standards. Before we get to that specific example, I'd like to take a moment and ask you to please subscribe to my channel and like this video. I greatly appreciate your support. Now let's get back to the video. This is a sample PDF that was made in Canva and exported out to a PDF. I then used Adobe Acrobat Pro to make this PDF accessible. So the first thing that I want to do to determine how I know that this PDF is accessible is to open up the tags panel. Now, to do that, I'm simply going to select the tags panel from the far left column of this document. If you don't have the tags view available, you can right click in this small section and select tags. Next, I'm going to select the first tag in my document, which is the document tag. This is the first bucket that contains all of the structure for this entire document. Now, if I use my down arrow key on my keyboard, as I walk through the tags panel, what I'm looking for is that all of the tags are actually in the tags panel. There isn't content that's missing, and we have an appropriate structure applied. You may have noticed the pink box appear as I move through the content in this page. This is because if I right click in the tags panel, I can select the option highlight content, which brings up this pink box and allows me to really determine whether or not the content has been tagged on the page. The first element that I go over in this page is a figure tag. And this is the logo that I used to use for a previous business. And that is an appropriate tag structure because this is in fact a figure. If I right click the figure and select properties, I can determine that there is an appropriate alternate text applied for this object. If I move through the content, I now have an H1 or a heading level 1 for my top level heading. I then have paragraph text underneath it. I have a heading 2 with the word headings selected. So let's go back into the tags panel, and I'm just going to use the down arrow key, and I'm going to walk the tags panel to ensure all the content is in the right order on this page. I have a heading 2, a list item, a heading level 3, another list item, a figure tag. And what I'm trying to determine is just to make sure that everything is actually in the page. If there was content that was not showing up in the tags panel, I would need to review and use a tool to make sure that the content was tagged. So let's just walk through the rest of this. And it appears to me that all of the content is appropriately tagged in this document. Now there's another step that I wanna do to ensure the accessibility. I'm gonna open up the metadata of this program. I'm gonna open up the metadata of this document by selecting file and then selecting properties. Then on the description tab, I can determine that I have a title, an author, subject, and keywords applied. Now the final step to determine the accessibility of this particular document is actually, I'm going to run the accessibility checker. So to do that, from the tools menu on the right side of my page, I'm gonna select the accessibility button, and then I'm gonna select accessibility check. From here, I'm gonna ensure all the categories are selected, so 32 out of 32, and then I'm gonna select start checking. This runs a scan, and on the left-hand side, I can review all of the results. Now, something that you'll notice is that there are two elements that will always be needs manual check, and that is our reading order, which is determined primarily by the tags panel, and that our color contrast needs a manual check. Now, I'm not gonna test the color contrast in this video. You can test it in one of my other videos, but just know that I have tested the color contrast here in this purple and black and white passes my color contrast requirements. So I can safely determine that this document passes my accessibility checker standards. Now, if I wanted to go above and beyond, I would actually pull up JAWS or NVDA and test this document. Thank you for joining me today as we walked through an overview of PDF accessibility. Please join me in my future videos by hitting the subscribe and like button. I can be your personal accessibility expert, so let me help you get accessible.